So, you've got a shot and someone's asked you to put in a CG object. Which is all fine and dandy, until you ask them whether they got all the stuff you need to actually do that. Namely, an environment map. What we need is a 360 picture or a photo of a chrome ball on the location. We need that so we can match the reflections and the lighting of the original footage. Well, let's say they didn't get any of that. Before, we were doomed to go online and try to find something similar looking on HDRI even. But now, if you're ever in a pinch, here's something new you can try. Let's go into Photoshop and use its generative AI to fill in a reflective chrome sphere into the picture. Sometimes it does whatever, but it's supposed to fill in the image with some awareness of the rest of the picture. In my case, I had to add on ground to the prompt to make it figure out where exactly it needed to be, and that gave me some perfect results of convincing chrome balls I can use. And now I just need to crop it and make it fit into a square. Over in Blender, we'll set up the project so we can see the background image, and for the world texture, we'll use nodes. This is where we usually add the HDRI, but instead we're using the picture of the chrome ball. To make this work, we also have to set the drop-down menu to use mirror ball. Now, let's insert a 3D sphere with a metallic texture, and once we set the shading to smooth, we have an actual 3D representation of our chrome ball with fully functional reflections. The sky isn't quite right yet, that's because our mirror ball doesn't have the advantage of actually being high dynamic range, but we can give it some more fake range using curves. And there we have it. The mirror ball is of course just a proof of concept. Once we know that works, we can be pretty sure anything else will work too. So tell me, what will you be using this trick for?